Welcome everyone to our inaugural video in a series we hope will be a fun and engaging look into the exciting world of DSPs here at TI. I'm Mark, this is Arnone, and we'll be talking about DSPs, whether they're better or worse than FPGAs, why programming DSPs are easier than you think, and a whole lot more. But let's start with a question that we've heard brought up a few times in the last several years. With increasing advances in general purpose processors like ARM and the advancements of GPUs and FPGAs, coupled with several chip vendors not named TI pulling back from the DSP space, there are some wondering if this signals the end of the standalone DSP. So I ask you, Arnone, are DSPs dead?
Are DSPs dead? You know, being inside TI, Mark, for both you and I think this is a really tough question to hear because, you know, I think people asking that question don't realize that DSPs are actually all around us. Like, for example, does your cell phone work?
Yes.
Did you know that almost every time you make a cell phone call, it goes through a TI DSP in the base station tower?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, well, of course, you're at TI. But people out there may not know that. The DSPs are involved in cell phone calls all the time. What about movies? You like movies?
I love movies.
So TI DSPs are involved in taking the movie experience to the home and home theater in most people's living rooms or, you know, home theaters all the time. So I think people asking that just really don't understand where DSPs are used today.
Yeah, you know, and it's an interesting question because I've heard it too, right? And I probably heard it more a couple years ago, you know, when TI was announced that it was pulling back in the wireless space, and a lot of people out there kind of equated that to maybe TI's pulling out of the processor space, the DSP space. Well, that's simply not the case, right? TI is investing heavily in the DSP space. We've got a great roadmap, and our customers are very excited about roadmap. The ones who have seen it when we show it to them, they're very excited about it. So the future of DSP is actually really strong.
Yeah, I completely agree. Okay, so we agree that DSPs are very, very much alive. But, you know, DSPs have a lot of competition out in the world. There's more competition for the board space, for that compute element on the card. And, you know, FPGAs are quite often what we're competing against, and they are annoyingly faster, cheaper, and not quite as power hungry as they used to be. So given that FPGAs show up a lot, Mark, why would someone choose DSP over FPGA?
All right, there's a lot of reasons. I'm going to oversimplify here for the sake of brevity. But if you care about size, if you care about power, or if you happen to have a complicated algorithm that, you know, isn't doing just the same thing over and over, then I think in that case, DSPs are almost always a better choice than FPGAs. But like I said, that is an oversimplification, right? Each has their own value depending on the system. FPGAs are good at, you know, very parallel processing type things, sometimes bringing in a lot of connectivity. But I think in a lot of systems, you can actually see the usage of both,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I agree. I think there's a lot of confusion. I think they try to compare, you know, apples to apples, like, oh, you use an FPGA or you use a DSP. But, you know, really, they're very fundamentally different. You know, FPGAs are a sea of gates. It's like having an ASIC. It's not that programmable. It is, as you said, really good at doing one thing very, very well. But it's not so good when you have to do a complex algorithm. So sometimes putting that up front with its connectivity and then going to the complex algorithm stuff that changes over time, or maybe it's not running the same thing all the time, then DSPs are a great solution. So, I think people don't quite get that it's really apples to oranges.
Yeah, and I think what we're both kind of saying is they each kind of have their strengths. Sometimes you can use both. There are a lot of instances where the DSP is better, but in a lot of instances, you can actually get away with both.
Yeah, and we've seen some, you know, system designs where they're both used effectively. I mean, there's some DSP-only ones, but there's also some where they're both.
So not always an either-or, but there are times DSPs preferable, but not always either-or.
I agree.
All right, let's talk about actually programming the DSP. As much as we like to say DSPs are easy to program, this is still considered daunting to those unfamiliar with it. Arnone, what do you have to say to those who are concerned about learning to program the DSP, and what is TI doing to help them?
Actually, my favorite saying here is no assembly required. I mean, it may be back in the old days, you know, the old timers had to program in assembly language, but, you know, I came to the DSP world about 10 years ago. I came from MATLAB programming, came Visual C programming. When I picked up the TI tools, it was all C programming. It was a very familiar GUI-based environment. The compiler was great. The code, I really had to do very little optimization by hand, and certainly nothing with assembly. So, you know, I think TI tools are, you know, if people are afraid to use a DSP because they're afraid of assembly language or what it's going to be like, I think that fear is, you know, really should be removed.
Okay, well, you just called me an old timer because I'm one of those guys who actually programmed the DSP in assembly, right? I don't even think I knew we had a compiler at first. It was all assembly. But, you know, this is almost 20 years ago. The tools now are drastically different. Back when I was programming, right, the tools were DOS-based. It was archaic. Back then, programming DSP was hard.
Yeah, you probably had to walk uphill to work and glass for keyboards or something.
Hey, things were
glass,
different in my
charts,
time, right? And it was a lot harder. Now, the days, anyone coming out of college can do DSP.
Yes.
Yeah, this old timer.
All right,
you've made a point.
It's easy now. Definitely not like that.
No.
All right, Mark, let's move to the wrap-up.
Let's do it.
So for engineers out there looking to see a good movie, I know you're a huge movie buff. Would you recommend The Theory of Everything or The Imitation Game?
Tough one. You know, anything based on Hawking is really incredible. We actually have codenamed a chip, Hawking, But you know, the imitation game is really that good. I'll have to go with that, and I'll just recommend that we codename a chip Turing in the future.
Sounds good.
Arnold, what happened to our award-winning blog, The Multicore Mix?
That blog, The Multicore Mix, has been brought into a new blog called The Process. The Process is a blog that you can learn everything about processors inside TI. Lots of good content, both from inside TI, like yours truly and yourself, as well as the community contributing to The Process. So please check it out. Mark, what's the coolest thing you've seen at TI DSP used in?
All right, I've got a lot of choices, but I'm actually going to have to go with a portable ultrasound, right? It's an ultrasound that we've helped make smaller that you can carry out to, you know, disaster relief sites and every place. But also, the important thing is you can use it in veterinary clinics, so people can actually use it to help diagnose what's wrong with my dog. And anything to help save my dog is a cool product.
Well, I'm a huge dog fan too, so you're making mine sound quite trivial, because I'm in love with the sports stuff you can do with it. They've put it in basketballs to measure shot angles and improve your game, and you know, I've seen it coming out in new sports equipment, so that was going to be my choice. But
well, you know, I like that if that can prove that I'm a better player than you, so we'll have to check that out.
Yeah, I don't think anything can do that, but thanks. Yeah.
Well, that's it. Our time is up. Thanks for taking a break with us. Tweet us your questions and comments using the hashtag DSP Break, and we'll address them in future videos.
Don't forget to follow us on Twitter. Check out ti.com/dreamdsp for all the latest info and material on TI DSPs. To help you remember DSP, think design smarter products.